वेलकम टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर क्लास माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11। आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द चैप्टर द गिफ्ट ऑफ इंडिया। द थीम ऑफ दिस पोयम इज पैट्रियटिज्म। पैट्रियटिज्म इज द थीम ऑफ दिस पोयम and this poem is related to World War I, which was fought between 1914 to 1918 by Sarojini Naidu, the poet. The poem starts with a question. The poet asks a question to the Britishers, to the alien. You see the first stanza. There are four stanzas in this poem. First stanza is there aught you need that my hands withhold? Is there aught? Is there anything you need that my hands withhold? Is there anything you need that I have not given you? Each and everything I have given you. The poet says, the speaker is Mother India here. Mother India is the speaker. The speaker, Mother India, addresses the erstwhile Britishers, formerly in the past, Britishers who ruled over India. Mother India addresses the Britishers. The Britishers snatched what rich gifts of raiment, cloths. Raiment means cloth. Rich gifts of raiment or grain or gold. The Britishers snatched away many precious things from Mother India. Mother India says, you have taken each and everything. What you not snatched? You have taken away many precious things like raiment, cloths, precious cloths, grains and gold. You have snatched away, you have taken away rich, precious cloths, grains and gold. Lo, I have flung to the east and the west priceless treasures torn from my breast and yielded the sons of my stricken womb to the drum beats of the duty, the sabers of doom. Here lo is used here to call attention. Exclamative sign is put here, lo. Lo used to call attention. Lo, I have sent my sons, my brave soldiers to the east and the west to fight. I have sent to the east and the west. I have sent my soldiers, I have sent my sons to the east and west. Priceless treasures. Priceless means here brave soldiers. Priceless treasures torn from my breast and yielded and provided the sons of my stricken womb to the drum beats of the duty, the sabers of doom. The sabers of doom means destructive weapons of war. You have taken each and everything. But most precious thing that you have snatched, you have taken away, were the priceless lives of Indian soldiers who fought for their masters in distant foreign lands in the East and the West. These soldiers listened to the call and yielded the son of my striking moon to the drum beats of the duty, the sabers of doom. These soldiers listened to the call of their duty when the drums of war were beaten. As soon as they listened the drum of war, they made themselves ready to fight. They fought bloody wars with their weapons. They fought bloody wars with their weapons, even without knowing for what cause they were fighting. They did not know the cause, but they were fighting for their masters, as they were their slaves. In stanza number 2, the poet says, gathered like pearls in their alien grave. Alien grave means graves in foreign lands. Silent they sleep by the Persian waves. Persian waves means the sea beaches of Persia, Iran, now in Iran. The sea beaches of Persia, Iran. Scattered like shells on Egyptian sands. Egyptian sand means here the deserts of Egypt. They lie with pale brows, symbol of death. Pale brows means here symbol of death. And brave broken hands, they are strewn, scattered. Strewn means scattered, like blossoms mown down by chance. Cut down flowers, mown down by chance means cut down flowers in the meadows, on the blood brown meadows. Blood brown means here red brown. Meadows means grassland of Flanders and France. Flanders and France. The poet says here, the poet here offers brilliant images by similes to commemorate the sacrifices made by Indian soldiers during the World War I. The soldiers who were as valuable as pearls were killed and buried in graves by the shores of Persia, which is now in Iran. The soldiers who lay down their lives in Egypt were found scattered on the sands as shells are found scattered on sands. The soldiers who lay down their lives in Egypt were found scattered on sands as shells are found scattered on sands. They lay dead, their death being signified by pale brows and their bravery by broken hands. In another beautiful image, the poet compares the dead soldiers to flowers. The dead soldiers to flowers. Here, written here, you see the line, they are strewn like blossom, they are strewn like, they are scattered like blossoms, flowers, So the dead soldiers to flowers that are cut down without any plan. The poet compares the dead soldiers to flowers that are cut down without any plan, that remain scattered and uncared for. This is what happened to the Indian soldiers whose dead bodies were left unattended on the grassy fields in Flanders. Flanders means here Belgium and France. Whose dead bodies were left unattended, uncared. There was no one who could care the dead bodies of the soldiers, were left unattended on the grassy fields in the Belgium, means here Flanders, and France. The blood of the soldiers colored the fields red. The blood of the soldiers colored the fields red. Can you measure? Again, there is a question. This question, again, the question is given here. The question is asked, can ye measure the grief of the tears I weep? Mother India asks. Mother India asks, can ye measure the grief of the tears I weep, or compass the woe of watch I keep, or the pride that thrills through my heart's despair, and the hope that comforts the anguish of prayer, and the far sad glorious vision I see of the torn red banners of victory. Here, compass. Compass means comprehend. Comprehend. Woe means sorrow. Thrill means pierces. Despair, hopelessness. Anguish means mental pain. Far means here distant, and red banners is used for bloody banners. Here the speaker, Mother India, asked the petitioners if they could ever measure the tears of her grief and know the extent of her woes or sadness at the death of her brave sons. The question is being asked in this stanza by Mother India from the Britishers, if they could ever measure the tears of her grief and know the extent of her woes, sorrows at the death of her brave sons. She asked if they could ever know the extent of her pride over their bravery. The pride that makes her forget her despair. The pride that makes her forget her despair, hopelessness. She again asks if they could know the hope in her heart that comforts the anguish of her prayer. In fact, she has a mix of feelings. She has a mix of feelings when she thinks of the sacrifices of her great heroes. She has a sad vision of the bloody flag wavering, proclaiming victory. The flag was wavering when the victory was proclaimed. She has a sad vision of the bloody flag wavering. The soldiers died out. The soldiers died, but they won a decisive victory for their masters. The soldiers fought and died. They martyred, but they won a decisive victory for their masters. In last stanza, the poet says, when the terror and the tumult of hate shall cease and life be refashioned on anvils of peace, and your love shall offer memorial thanks to the comrades who fought on the dauntless ranks, and you honor the deeds of the dauntless ones, remember the blood of my martyred sons. Here, tumult means violent commotion. Anvil means iron blocks, strong foundation. Dauntless means courageous. And here in the last line, blood means here sacrifices. Here, in the last stanza, the poet says, the speaker concludes on a note of hope. The poet concludes on a note of hope. A day is not far. The day will soon come. A day is not far when the violent commotion of hate, that is war, would come to an end. The hate. That is war would come to an end. Life would be peaceful and normal again. There will be normalcy again. The speaker is hopeful that the bravery of Indian soldiers would be remembered with gratitude. The brave acts of the dead Indian soldiers would be acknowledged and honored. The coming generations would remember those who laid down their lives in alien lands. The poet hopes that the sacrifices will be remembered by the coming generation, and the soldiers will be remembered. The coming generation would remember those who laid down their lives in alien lands. The poem is anti-war poem, because war is basically painful and destructive. It snatches precious sons from their mothers. So we can say that this poem is anti-war poem. You can say the theme is anti-war, as war is basically painful and destructive. It gives only destruction and doom. It snatches precious sons from their mothers. This is the end of the poem. If you have any problem in this poem, please ask me. Thank you so much.